Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might and Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here. Now, where we last left off, we had talked to the Dragon Pharaoh, and he told us to go get the Soul Box in Olympus. So we're going to go ahead and just go do that. This actually shouldn't be too big of a problem at all. Of course, copy protection. And once we have that, I think we go and talk to Korak again, and then we can confront Sheltem.
Okay, go ahead.
There's stuff interspersed in there, but if I play my cards right, we should in theory be able to finish the game this episode. We'll read the scroll. Cyrano sells the password. Now, I actually know what the password is here, so I'm not going to worry about it. If I recall correctly, the password is tribbles. Search the drain. BL, yeah. They give you the hints for, like, word for word. But you don't need that. IB, you don't need that because I actually know what the hint is. And the reason it says Cyrano sells the password is because Cyrano sells tribbles, I believe. Oh god, the vowel is nice. Yeah, this is like the solutions to every puzzle. Alamar's true name, for instance, is Sheltem. This is basically the answer to every like hard puzzle in the game. Read the plaque. Oh god. The plaque at the base of the statues reads, Dragon's orb the world shall roam, yet must again return to home. Pharaoh's magic back in its place helps to free the visitor from space. Code's the key to thinking machines. Starman knows the truth about Xeen. Okay. As you can see, there is a passage over there, but I don't believe we can get to that. I don't think we can teleport to that. If I recall correctly, I think what we're looking for, I think it's this one. It will. What's the password? Tribble. Correct! It's like I knew. And then this takes us up here. And here's the soul box. Chunk found it. So we can just go on and leave. And I don't think we necessarily really have too much to do here. I think I did want to compare some gear.
See anything you like?
No. Yes. The hand axe of the scimitar. I want to. Oh, it's not broken. Whoops. Alright, 52 to 56, 52 to 60, okay, so that is in fact better, and I think everybody else is set, 52 to 54. It does less damage than his dagger, but I don't believe Chunk can use the hand. It's a shame that it's only worth 500, I'm not gonna sell it, I don't think, not yet, because I think Rove can cast Enchant Item, can't he? Yeah. On whom? On the Obsidian Axe, Enchant. Ah, not enchantable.
See,
damn it. Alright, well, I gave it the old college try. Now, let's see here. He does have a scimitar and a spear that are obsidian for relatively low prices, too, all things considered. The rest of his stuff, though, not really all that interesting. I mean, we can go ahead and get rid of the rest of this stuff. I'm really not too worried about gear from this point on. We're pretty much set with regards to everything except probably resistances, but I don't know how much we'll be bumping into when it comes to enemies that are going to be hitting our resistances particularly hard. Excuse me, I apologize. I know there are some enemies in... God, what's it called? There's a castle that we go through for Sheltem, and it's kind of a pain, but... I'm not worried.
I'm back soon.
I don't remember if there's a bank here, but I would like to go to the bank and deposit all of this money that we are carrying. There's training, no level cap here. There's the Mage's Guild, this is the temple. Okay, so nothing fun here. So we should be able to just No, it's taking us to the Great Pyramid. Oh, that's right. I actually didn't drop one because this place is like just a short walk away from here. Yes. Oh, hey, copy protection. Get out of here. Okay. Hey, Korak.
Ah, a soul box. You have done well. I will hide in the box while you take me to Sheltem. Once you're in Sheltem's presence, throw the box to the ground, and I will come out and fight him. Be careful. If you lose the box or are killed, Xeen is doomed.
Only mostly. Alright, so now we have Korak in his soul box. And we are ready. The music in here, I don't know why, it reminds me of music from the Shadowrun game on the Genesis. I don't know. I think it's the MIDI instruments that they use, just in general, I guess, kind of remind me of Genesis music, because it always had that really, like, twangy, metallic sound to it. I don't know. Okay, so we have to find Sheltem's castle now, which I believe is floating around out here somewhere. Which, this is probably going to be more of a pain than it ought to be. But, oh hey, lava dwellers, you guys are no threat to anybody. Okay, here's his castle. Yes. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do in here is we're going to sleep. And now we're going to buff. And I'm going to save. And if we finish this game this episode, I'll probably call it there. There is a... This game actually has three entrances. Ha! Endings. The cloud side, the dark side, and then there is a World of Xeen ending that you get if you have both of them installed. And we are going to be going for all three endings. So... In this episode, I'm going to play until we hit the... Seriously, I legit can't get that down. Wow. We're going to play until we hit the dark side ending. So I guess we're going to etherealize through this and see how we fare. I think this is an annihilator. As you can see, yeah, they have, I think, like 16 attacks around, but we drop them pretty well. And there's another one, which means that there's probably more, so I'm just going to jump into it. It might actually be 8 attacks, and there were just 2 of them. That's probably more accurate. But yeah, these guys, I think we've got them. And this is, of course, where Might and Magic takes the kind of hard turn into sci-fi, which is one of the things that I always found kind of fascinating about the series, is that, you know, it's like your standard typical medieval fantasy about 80% of the game, and then bam, sci-fi. And they're pretty much all like that in some extent. Can we open it here now? And I'm gonna sleep again just to get our hit points and stuff back. They're kind of all like that. I don't know about the first game. I know the second one, there is some time travel that goes on. I know the third one has some futuristic stuff in it. This one, obviously. 6? Thinking on it, I actually don't remember if 6 has any future stuff in it. 7 does. I remember there being phasers in 7. So what is this? Lava head. Firepower field operational. Alright. Air power field operational. Statue speaks. I'm the statue dedicated to honoring Alamar's skillful rulership of the realms he has controlled. In all kingdoms lucky enough to benefit from Alamar's wise counsel and firm guidance, crime has decreased and production increased. Further, social deviance has virtually disappeared, while complete obedience, a behavior desirable in lower life forms, has risen dramatically. Okay. I think they all say that. Dedicated to honoring Alamar's glorious vengeance against the ancients. From his destruction of ancient science projects to the subversion and theft of the Xeen structure, Alamar has caused more damage to the ancients' works and projects than any other rogue AI the ancients have ever had the misfortune to create. Okay, and then there are these for all four elements, which I believe... Yeah, you come up here and, like, you can't get through these. Right. Dang it, wrong button. Trying to remember how you destroy the field, though. Fire time. Oh god, I don't know what the times are. At least not off the top of my head. And I don't think we can just, like, etherealize through. It's not gonna be easy. Access to the upper floor is denied. So what I'm gonna do, since we can't go up, we can go down. I think. Yes. Okay, and this, if I recall correctly, yeah, because I'm fairly certain I showcased this in Clouds of Xeen while we were still doing it. This area actually attaches to Shangri-La. I don't remember where, but I do remember that it does. Rogue's kind of getting the crap beaten out of him. Thankfully, at this point in time, we actually have enough, you know, mana that I can afford to just pop the occasional power cure on him. He's really the only one I'm worried about, because he's the only one that has health low enough that, you know, it becomes a problem. go ahead and etherealize through this. Oh, we've got a pack of them here. At least three. Okay. In that case, we'll pop a Divine Intervention, sure. And hit them with a Starburst. I don't remember. Okay, so they are not magic immune, which is good. Makes things a little easier there. Want to kind of slowly edge forward so that I don't accidentally have them shooting at me. Which, you know, that kind of makes a bad time for everybody. Oh, and I think, I can't remember what those things are. Autobot. So we are now killing Transformers. We've come full circle. Autobots, I think, are decidedly less dangerous. Xeen Power Juice. Alright, they're both saying yes, so Rove. Plus 5 levels. Alright. The casters get those because they're getting more out of it, I think, than our melees. Our melees would be getting, like, probably additional attacks. I want to say that's probably about it, I would guess. So, yeah, I'm just going to feed these to the casters because they're basically who do the brute work. The majority of the work for my party here at this point in time. I mean, the melee is melee really good, but, you know, it's Gold Leaf keeping everybody healed. It's Rove teleporting us all over the place and getting us in melee. And the melees, their damage would go up a little. It would probably be best to throw it on, I want to say Brunhilde, she's our knight, right? Yeah. So I'm actually going to give these to the front row here. Alright, plaque. 9 is the time. Alright, I need paper, and I'm going to write that down, because it's almost like it's a hint or something. 9 is the time. Okay. So we've been over there. We have 2 levers. That opened a door, and that opened a door. Well, they opened walls, I should say. Yeah, and this is Shangri-La. Like, I think right here, the west of us. Right here. This will take us back to Shangri-La, which we don't actually want to go there yet. Now, if you come through here when you're done with, you know, Cloudside thing, and you know, oh, I'm like this supreme badass, I'm pretty sure I gave a quick preview of what happens there, where you basically just get utterly smashed, because one of these things probably does enough damage at that point in the game to wipe your party. Okay, have her throw another Divine Intervention. Chunk. Heh, Rove. I suppose I can go with a Starburst. Why not? Let's give this guy some arrows. He should be in red by now. I should have stepped forward, but hindsight is 20/20, I suppose. Okay, so what does this one say? Oh god. Not only is Almar a wise and just ruler, Almar is sporting as well. Almar graciously grants clever opponents a chance to defeat him by leaving hints and clues to bypass his defenses. But know this, O enemies of Almar the Benevolent, that Almar takes pleasure in the failure of his opponents, especially when they come close to success, and you will fail. Okay, these guys can only melee, so I'm not too worried about him. I love how it's like just a little dude in there piloting this thing. It looks like he's hitting a button with his face. Oh god, the message to the plaque reads fire, earth, water, air. I wonder if those are maybe the times? So, it's counting time! Let's see here. Air, earth, fire, water. I'm just gonna put dits down here. So, fire, earth, water, air. Earth. Fire. Water, air, earth. Fire, air, water. Earth. Water. And earth, fire, air, water. Earth, fire, air, water. Okay, so those might be the numbers that we need. I mean, the previous thing said that the time is 9 is the time. But I don't know how much we're going to trust that. So back to walking. So there's Shangri-La. Not too interested. Might as well come over here. Like, these things I think are worth like 1,000,000 experience points a piece or just some ridiculous number. Come on, guys. There we go. fussing with my mouse pad here because I don't want my mouse like riding up the side of my damn screen like it's doing. Get out of here, cursor. Nobody got time for this. Yeah, okay. Well, I think, Swell, it is time for you to cast Divine Intervention. Top everybody off. So we have a skull and a thing, a box. Chunk, key to Dragon Tower. That is... I don't remember if that's optional or not. Access denied, do you not have the proper ID? Okay, so apparently we do have to do Dragon Tower, I think. Like I said, I don't remember entirely how much of it is, you know, optional side areas. I seem to recall having to run through Dragon Tower, which if we do, there's probably going to be some whining on my part about that. Alright, so let's see if this works. Because we should, in theory, have not the nine. We should have the numbers here. Casting spells. Alright, fire time. So this should be 5. Okay. Air time. This should be 4. No, I don't want to turn it. Okay. Okay. Earth time is 7. Yeah, I think I see, like, paths appearing. Water time. 5. Okay. Oh, I think I see what it's doing. It's making, like, paths for us. I want to see if these things still say they're active. Alright. Yeah, it seems like it's making paths for... And, of course, our buffs wear off. Not one divine intervention, I just want a day of protection, and you conveniently have enough mana for it, and a day of sorcery. Like, I wonder if we can jump. I'm sure we can't. Oh, wow, we actually can't. Can we walk through this? No. Okay. That doesn't surprise me. It's, dang it. It seems like they don't want to give us the easy way in here, but knowing that we can jump, we might have a way in. And or not. See, can I just teleport? There's no way. Yeah, I was gonna say, there's no way they're gonna just let us teleport through this. It's the earth one. I wonder if I can pull it back. Water, no. Where was earth? Of course it'll be the last one that I find, because that's just the way of things. Air, yeah, see? I told you. It's always the last one, because that is just... That's my luck. Yeah, let's turn it and see if that does anything. See, it was on 7 before, so let's set it to 6. Maybe 4, actually. Because if it's going to be, like, you know, an actual clock... God damn it. Here, let's see if this moved it. Yeah, that moved it. Alright, so I think it's 4 that we want here. It's either going to be 4 or 3. It might be 3. And they expect us to jump. Here, let's find out. Yep! Oh, or I'm dumb. It is 4, I think. It's 1 too far, but I can't math because I'm stupid. Okay. Yeah. There we go. Time is not right. Access denied. Well, if the time is supposed to be 9, then I suppose we can just set them all... Damn it. To 9. And then the letters that we got there are different. Because, yeah, this is probably just going to make a bridge over for us then, isn't it? Yeah, this is where they all intersect, which it looks like it's going to be. Who'd have thunk it? Certainly not this guy. Alright. Yeah, okay. What is Alamar's true name? Sheltem. Access approved. Okay, so now I think we can go upstairs. Whether or not we want to, I don't know. So I'm gonna save. I can't remember if this is like the end of the game right here. I don't think it is. Oh, Jesus. Of course it's gonna make us fall. Well, oh, no! I think I might know what they want of me here. This might have to do with that. Oh, God. Yeah, I know what this is. I know exactly what this is. We've got to go back down into the dungeon unless we writ it in our journal. Which I'm gonna guess we didn't, and there's a damn plane going overhead. Whatever. Nine is time. Oh, thank Christ we did. That is handy. I'm gonna actually write this down. F-E-W-A-E. I'm gonna do it in chunks of five. E-F-F-W-A. F-F-W-I. E-F-A-W-E. A-W-E. E-W-W-E-F. E-W-W-E-F. A-W. A-W! Alright, so basically I think what this is doing is telling us the proper way that we're supposed to walk through this room. Okay, so, fire, earth, and water, air, earth, earth, fire, fire, water, air. I'm gonna save. Okay, earth, fire, air. Earth, fire, air, water, earth, earth, water, water, earth, fire, air, water, bam! Oof! That was a brain tickler. And I just skipped the text that said, alright, end game.
Come to me.
Yes, it is I. You have nowhere to run, Sheltem.
Nor do you. I'm ready for you this time. This fight will be your last.
I cannot fail.
Admit your defeat, Korak.
I do. Initiate self-destruct code 001.
What? No! No!
And that is the ending of Darkseid, and this is what they give you. And so I love it. It's just like the explosions, and then, hey, here's the Dragon Fair, and guess what? Your final score is like 870 million. Send this score to the Ancients' headquarters, where you'll be added to the Hall of Legends. Sadly, I was... When this came out, I was too young to have actually played through it, so I never got to do that. Otherwise, I would. Adventurers, I have saved your game in Castleview. The world of Xeen still needs you. Indeed, load your game and come visit me in the Great Pyramid for further instructions. Alright. And that was the Dark Side of Xeen. So, over the next, I don't know, couple episodes, it'll probably be... I would say 2 or 3 episodes at most to complete the World of Xeen ending. It's really not particularly long or involved. It's some light puzzling and... go and collect item type quests. Not too bad. Anyways, thank you for watching. That was Dark Side of Xeen. We still have a little bit left to go, but I'm going to be saving that all for next time. So until then, folks, take it easy.